Welcome dear students. So we are in the discussion of fourth unit topics. Already we have completed the chapter 1 conventional grinding process, and we completed two topics from the chapter 2, that is special surface finishing processes, the honing and the lapping process. And in this video lecture we are going to discuss about the electrochemical grinding and the super finishing processes. So the electrochemical grinding, it's actually a electrochemical process. In general, it is called as chemical machining. And this process is the reversal of the electroplating concept, which you already know from your school days, how a metallic material is coated over another metallic material. It's nothing but electroplating process. This process is the reversal of that concept. And here, the actual working concept is controlled anodic dissolution of the workpiece at atomic level. So in that way, the material is removed from the workpiece in atom level. So the material removal rate here is very, very low, and it is completely under our control. So very high level of accurate machining is possible in this process, but the material removal rate is very, very low when compared with the other processes. Here the proposed, it is proposed to machine extremely hard materials like titanium, copper, inconel and carbide, and there is no possibility for machining dielectric materials by this process, because the electrical conductivity in the workpiece as well as tool is very much essential in this kind of operation. And the material removal rate is actually not depends on the hardness of the material. Whatever it may be, the hardness of the material, the material removal rate is completely independent on the hardness of the material. And soft materials also can be used as tool material. Here there is no, nearly there is no tool wear. So not like other process. Here the tool material can be very, very soft when compared with the workpiece material. And the material removal is not only based on the physical force, it again based on the electrochemical reaction only. And this actually the concept, how the electrochemical grinding is carried out. Actually, the workpiece and the tool material are completely immersed in a electrolyte solution. For example, here I am showing you a electrolyte solution, neutral solution. Here, the water mixed with sodium chloride is used as electrolyte. When the workpiece is connected with positive terminal of the supply and tool is connected with the negative terminal of the supply, when low voltage high current DC power supply is switched on here, the sodium chloride and water are ionic dissociated with each other. See, that sodium chloride will splitted into Na plus and Cl minus. The water H2O will splitted into H plus and OH minus. So in this way, the sodium chloride and the water atoms are ionically dissociated. And during that process, the Fe plus ions will detached from the workpiece and moves towards the negative terminal of the supply. And in the negative terminal of the supply, electrons will be released. And during the operation, the Fe2 plus ions will combine with the Cl minus ions and will form metal chlorides. And the Fe2 plus ions will combine with the OH minus ions to form ferrous oxides. This ferrous chloride and the ferrous oxide are generally considered as sludge, and that is the waste materials, and just floats on the surface. And the H plus ions will combine with the electrons released from the negative terminal and form as the hydrogen gas. So in this way, the material loss happened in the anode in atomic level. In this way, we can remove the material. So this is the actual concept of material removal, and there is no deposition is happening in the tool material in this operation. So in this way, the material removal is happened in the workpiece. See, this is another graphical representation how the electrochemical machining is carried out. Actually, we are customizing this equipment setup similar to the grinding process. The concept of material removal is electrochemical machining only. We are customizing the equipment setup more related to grinding process, and we named it as electrochemical grinding. See here, the workpiece is here, and this is nothing but our tool material. The electrolyte supply is happened from the core of the tool, and the workpiece is connected with the positive terminal. Tool is connected with the negative terminal. Low voltage, high current DC power supply is employed here. During that operation, due to the electrochemical reaction, the anodic dissolution is happened in the workpiece. So it is connected with anode. That's why the material loss here is considered as anodic dissolution. So this anodic dissolution resulting the material loss in the workpiece, and based on the gap between the tool and the workpiece, the anodic dissolution rate may be changed. See here, the shape of the tool tip which is having interface with our workpiece. So based on the shape of the tool tip, the material loss rate is happening here. That's why we are getting the impressions in the workpiece very similar to the projection of our tool material. See, it is actually the equipment setup for the electrochemical grinding process, which is working on the concept of electrochemical machining. See, this is the power supply unit. Low voltage, high current DC power supply unit. Negative terminal connected with the tool. The tool here is nothing but a wheel, a metallic wheel. In the surface, lot of abrasive particles are embedded, and this metallic grinding wheel is connected with the negative terminal, and the positive terminal of the power supply is connected with the metallic workpiece. And during the operation, the electrolyte is supplied between the workpiece and the tool, and a small gap is maintained between the workpiece and the tool. In that place, the anodic dissolutions happened, and that material is removed in the workpiece. The released electrolyte is collected in the sump and recirculated after some cleaning processes. So in this way, the electrochemical machining is carried out by using this equipment setup. Here, the notable point is the material removal, 90% of the material removal happened due to the electrochemical machining concept only, and not like the conventional grinding process. The material removal happened because of the abrasive action between the abrasive particle of the grinding wheel and the workpiece. So the tool life is very, very high when compared with the conventional grinding operation. Let's see the process characteristics of this process. As I told you earlier, the life of grinding wheel in this electrochemical grinding process is very high, because 90% of the material removal is happened because of the electrolysis action, and only 10% is due to the abrasive action. So the ECG process is capable of producing very smooth and burr-free edges, not like the conventional grinding process. In the conventional grinding process, however, we are using the grinding wheel. After a prolonged usage, the surface finish may go wrong, may go very worse because of the prolonged usage. This kind of aging issues are not possible in case of electrochemical grinding process. The heat produced in the electrochemical grinding process also very, very less, and because of that, the distortion in the workpiece is nearly nil, and the major material removal activity in the ECG process occurs by the dissolving action only, as I told you earlier. So very little tool wear, and sometimes there is no tool wear we can find in the grinding wheel used in the electrochemical grinding. And very high brittle materials can be machined, which are all not possible in the conventional grinding process. And without any thermal damage and burr-free application also possible here. And this kind of electrochemical grinding can be used for production of tungsten carbide cutting tools, burr-free sharpening of hypodermic needles, and grinding of superalloy turbine blades, and aerospace honeycomb metals and removal of fatty cracks from steel structures. These kind of higher level applications are possible by using the electrochemical grinding process. Next, we are going to see about the super finishing operation, buffing. The buffing process is an extremely high surface finishing operation. The surface smoothness obtained in the buffing process is more than the electrochemical grinding also. So this buffing process stands as a super finishing process and able to produce very very high smooth surface with very very low material removal rate compared with all other surface finishing processes. And this is producing much higher lustrous and mirror like finishing which is not possible by the other finishing operations. And generally this process is carried out manually only and semi-automatic, partially manual, partially machine, for which the job is held against the rotating buffing wheel. And the tool here used is actually the buffing wheel. It is actually the optimum process to eliminate the scratch marks in the surface. For example, the car body scratches can be easily removed by using the buffing operation. And here the job, the actual working principle here is, the workpiece is brought into contact with the revolving buffing wheel, which is made up of, not with metal or anything else, the buffing wheel, that is the tool material here, is made up of cloth or leather or linen or canvas, which is charged with very fine abrasive particles with the help of a binding material. The abrasives used in this buffing wheel are iron oxide, chromium oxide, emery and some more. And the binding material which is used to bind these abrasive particles in the buffing wheel are wax, grease, paraffin and kerosene and sometimes turpentine oil. The rotating speed of the buffing wheel ranges from 30 meter per second to 40 meter per second. So the rotation is very very high. So these are all some photographic views of the buffing wheel. See here, the buffing wheels are not manufactured with any ceramic or metallic material. It's made up of leather or cloth or linen or canvas material. With various shapes and colors, we can see the buffing wheels, and it is able to rotate with the help of the rotating spindle. And the buffing machines are tabletop or floor mounted. See, this is a double head buffing machine, and it is loaded with two buffing wheels, and the floor mounted buffing wheels also possible. And this buffing machine is the portable or handy type, able to handle by the manually and move in any direction. And these are all some buffing machine applications. See, the buffing of metals is carried out in that way. It is actually the rotating buffing wheel. Against that, we are feeding our metallic workpiece in order to finish the surface into very high accuracy. Mirror finishing is possible by using this buffing process, and the car body scratches can be easily removed by using this buffing non-metal concept. And the ornamental items like studs or chains can also be polished by using this buffing wheels. And wooden buffing is more famous for giving a very high polished wooden articles by using this wooden buffing concept. And the flat surface of wood also can be polished into very high smooth by using this buffing wood. Thank you for listening.